What is this? Who are you? What have you done with Nisama? Oh. This is something everyone should see. There can be no doubt I gaze upon the last living wonder of the Serenus royalty. Those golden locks, witness how they gather in the morning sun and multiply its brilliance. The gentle lustre of those elegant wings manifest proof of royalty, as sure as I am alive. Magnificent, absolutely magnificent. A true work of art wrought in flesh and feather. All this beauty, mine. The fortune I paid the Raven King seems like a pittance compared to this treasure. What? Nesala sold me to you? You're exquisite, even in rage. Now if you behave yourself, I'll grant you a life of luxury. My nose! My beautiful nose! Bishop Oliver! You winged freak! He'll pay for that! No! You mustn't harm him! You mustn't ruffle a single feather on those gorgeous wings! My beauty, you mustn't be frightened. In time, you will come to see how kind and charitable a master I can be. This is madness! Oh, so frightening! How delicious! But I feel we must now be separated for a while. Loyal servants, attend to my words. You must not raise a hand to this one. Prepare his meals with care and do not disturb his rest. I would not see his countenance marred by displeasure. Herons, you see, are such delicate things. And then, at the proper time, yes, the proper time. When will it be? I say to you, those haughty senators and their ilk have looked down their noses at me for the last time. I shall show them all. Oh, but I must have a grand stage, one where none can fail to see me. The Serenus royals are creatures of legend, and when I arrive with one at my side, I can hardly wait to see Dugado's face. Nesala, you wretch! Curse your eyes! How dare you do this to me? Welcome back to Let's Play Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. Last I recorded, it's been about 30 days. Recently got back from a trip to North Carolina, which lasts me about 20 plus days. Had a good time down there. I did work at an animal hospital for a bit. We went down to South Carolina for all of one day. Don't ask how in the details. And a couple days ago, I came back, which was on Monday the 28th. Applied for a job, and I'm currently waiting back for a call for that. So that's all I've been up to. Absolutely freaking nothing, because by the time you see this, it'll probably be September, because I plan to put the first part tomorrow on August 1st, because it's currently July 31st. I have approximately, from this point forward, 26 days till school starts back up, which means I have 26 days to record the rest of this game. So, yeah. And then when Hyrule Warriors comes out, record that after I've done a playthrough for myself, because there's really no point in doing a blind playthrough in a Warriors game. Rather, there wouldn't be a problem to do a Warriors game blind, because it's technically just hack and slash, and I keep doing that. I'm sorry. I can't be trusted with wireless controllers, because I always fiddle with the bottom of it. And so, Tormod is telling Sanaki that she is lying about the whole liberation of the Nagus from 20 years past in the year 624 or something like that. Might have been 604 by that point. Hmm. Why ever would you put those words together, madam? If anyone's planning something, it's you.
Really?
And what could you possibly mean by that? Your last mission showed us the slave trade, and now you put us in contact with an underground emancipation group. From the very beginning, I found this whole arrangement a little odd. You have more vassals than you can use, yet you hire us for these missions. Your motivations have me puzzled. Ah, I see. Have you solved this puzzle of yours? You want to expose the depravity of the inner circles of power. But you don't want the general public to know that the majority of the Senate is involved in the slavery. And to think I thought you were as untutored as a wild monkey. You're actually quite bright. I didn't figure it all by myself. I have companions who I trust with my life. They helped. Hey, hold it! What in the world are you talking about? Would someone like to explain this to me? The apostles wear the light goose slavery. On top of that, it appears she intends to do something about this problem. Are you serious? I am. However, whether I succeed or fail depends largely on what you do next. So be it. I think it's time you told us about the next job you have lined up for us. I've received reports that Bishop Oliver, the Duke of Tunis, is up to something suspicious. Duke Tunis has a villa near the woods of Serenus. Go there, and return with irrevocable proof of whatever he's doing. If you succeed in this, I promise to support your Princess Lindsay with all the power at my command. We'll bring back whatever information it is you're looking for. Be ready for us. And to be completely honest, this chapter I have no problems with. The next one I have a problem with, and it is the longest chapter in the game. Bar none from previous games, because I dare say that chapter 17 of Path of Radiance is probably my longest chapter. First play that took me about 3 hours to do. I haven't recorded in a while, my throat's not really quite up to it, but hopefully it will adapt in the coming hour, because I would like to record all night long. It is currently 9:43 p.m. I will keep you posted upon like every three, maybe every four or five parts on what the time is currently, maybe six, seven, I don't know. I plan to record for quite a long time. I'd like to have a bit more of a backlog than what I do now. I had planned to upload throughout July. However, YouTube, for some reason, got rid of the scheduled uploader, so I've been confused as to what to do there. So I figure uploading the 1st of August would be the better alternative instead of uploading through July to September. And I can have it go from, say, Monday to Friday through September, October, November, spread it out as probably as far as I can without really having to worry about footage. But also being able to record stuff behind that so that we have something to go on in case I don't have time to record in the future, which will most likely happen since this semester in college I'm taking a 401 class, which means thesis papers and lots of time at the library. I am not going to slack off my work this time, because last semester all the recording and all the playing of the games and all the going to classes kind of took up my time, and I waited to the last 2 weeks to do all my paperwork, which wasn't really a smart idea. Although I got it all done in about, like, 4 days. I really didn't read this, because really, at some points, I don't really like reading a lot of the things. If I can get away with not reading some of these, then great. I don't have to. But if I have to, then alright. But I prefer to not have to read every line of dialogue. It would take forever, and we would be sitting here probably just reaching chapter 10, or not chapter 9, probably chapter 12, reading all the dialogue there is. However, it doesn't really help
just to even read it, because it pushes the parts quite a bit, but reading these would take forever, and I would rather not do that at the moment. And if I'm going to do it for any game, I'd probably do it for the GBA Fire Emblem games, because they don't have all this long text, which will take forever to read. Which is probably why I am waiting for Sacred Stones to get on the Wii U before I do that. Because I would really like to do Sacred Stones. Speaking of Sacred Stones, there are bonus maps in this game, which we will probably just do the Sacred Stones one, because I only have Fire Emblem 8 instead of 7 and 6. I don't even have 7. I missed out on 7 completely. As I've said numerous times before, my first Fire Emblem game was Sacred Stones, and I love that game. And I love every Fire Emblem game that I've played, with the exception of Radiant Dawn and Shadow Dragon. Although I love Shadow Dragon more than I do Radiant Dawn. I really did not like Radiant Dawn. I like Path of Radiance, just not Radiant Dawn. Although what I do have to say is that I do like the character developments, just that I don't like having to play through the game several numerous times to see all the support logs, which would take a very long time, and I don't have that kind of time anymore since I'm not... When this game came out, like, 2004, 2005, I'm not 13, I'm 21, I'll be moving out of this house soon. And I would rather not have to worry about playing a game just to fill up a support log if it's not handheld. Personally, I prefer to fill out a support log when it is a handheld game and not a console game, because the consoles take forever. Handheld, you can finish a chapter in like 20 minutes, tops. Or 10 if you grind like a madman. And grinding helps in Sacred Stones, which you don't have to grind. So in terms of this game, you really can't grind. That's really my only one real beef with certain Fire Emblem games. I mean, like, the games that go from chapter to chapter to chapter, instead of, like, ones with an overworld, like with Fire Emblem, Sacred Stones, and Awakening. I prefer the world map, because then I have a time to build up strength. Otherwise, here it's just chapter to chapter, and it kind of, at times, for me, doesn't seem to work. Well, normally because I think I'm always underprepared for certain chapters. May the last chapter of Shadow Dragon forever avoid my sight, because I hated that chapter. And I absolutely despise Radiant Dawn's first half with the Dawn Brigade, and I absolutely hate the Dawn Brigade. If they wanted to make a sequel to Path of Radiance, why not just use the characters from Path of Radiance? They're already better than the Dawn Brigade, why use them when you can use the older characters who will be infinitely better when you've played Path of Radiance first? I guess really what it matters is that you can't max out everybody in these chapter-to-chapter games. So when it comes to games that allow you to bring over save files, you can't really have everybody maxed out. And I prefer to have my things maxed out, because I like to be overpowered by the last chapter to just utterly wreck the final boss. That was 14 minutes spent on just that alone. God dang it. The characters like Stefan, it's pretty weird. Kind of just showed up to Ike and doesn't really have a reason for being here. Aside for talking to Mordecai in the last chapter, and technically, I think, being a certain type of being, it's kind of like the same as certain other characters. Sure, we'll study. Mm-hmm. Why is this theme playing? Huh. Well, okay then. That happened. I can soar up in support. Heck yes, support buddies. The rest of this part's gonna be basically support conversations. Next time's gonna be more or less the same thing, because we're still in the base. To be completely honest, I think this is probably the worst part about the console Fire Emblem games. Well, the ones that we've gotten. I don't know how the other ones handled. Although I know how Shadow Dragon handled, since they poured that to the DS, but these just seem to take so frickin' long compared to, like, handheld ones. Then again, having to have them battle, like, I don't think they have to be next to each other, but, like, in the same battle map, they have to be fighting an equal amount of battles or something to even have support at all. And even then, you only get 5 per playthrough, which doesn't really help in this game, but in games like Sacred Zones, different endings, because that game never got a sequel, and it makes me sad. Although, I would probably like a prequel more than a sequel, because we kind of killed off the last demon in Sacred Stones. I hope to crud we get a Sacred Stones on the Wii U Virtual Console, because I would like to play that one day. Now, I'd rather not use an emulator, because I learned the last time that I used one to not do that, because that's kind of cheating. Then again, the Wii U Virtual Console has an has a save state feature, which totally breaks the game. I just sped through that, I'm sorry. Soaring, yada yada yada. By the time this even goes up, Tales of Dysteria, with a Z, one of the characters is named Sori. S-O-R-E-Y. I thought of Soren for a bit, and then I thought sorry. Then Sori came to my mind, because I think that's probably the pronunciation they're going to use for that game, if Zestaria comes out within the next year. Otherwise, they're going to use sorry a lot, and I'd rather not see the word sorry pop up again in a Tales game ever since Symphonia and Symphonia 2, because those games, the most prominent word was sorry. I'd rather not hear it again. Zihar, Giliana, go! A support the crud out of these two, because I shipped them like crud. Right, this has to end soon, so we're probably going to speed along here for a bit. I really need to end up cutting this part short, because I don't want this going on forever, mainly because reasons. I don't want to have, like, 25-minute long parts every time. Right, at this point, we'll do more support conversations next time. Unless it's really going to take up too much time, I'd rather not. So, see you all next time on Let's Play Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. We didn't do a whole lot of playing. Really more a lot of reading and me talking about things, and that's the one thing I hate about the base of operations. See you all next time on Let's Play Fire Emblem Path of Radiance.